The time had come. The time when eternity would be altered forever. This was the moment when condemnation would meet redemption, when the free reign of darkness would meet the light of the world. The time was now. And as the curtains rolled back from a divinely set stage, all of creation rose and stood in silence.
The silence of Christmas began long before the birth of Christ.
For 400 years, God was silent. From the final words of the prophet Malachi until the proclamation of John the Baptist, from the time between the Old Testament and the New Testament, there were no prophecies, no revelations, no direct communications with his children. What kind of God would leave his people in silence for 400 years?
A God who keeps his promises. A God whose attention to detail would not allow the plan of redemption to unfold prematurely. You see, God is often silent while he is working. During those 400 silent years, God was resetting the world stage. Key prophecies were being fulfilled. The nations of the world were repositioning themselves to be in direct alignment with the scripture. For the first time in history, the Hebrew prophecies were being translated into another language, the universal Greek language, allowing for all nations to recognize the Messiah at just the right time. There was a plan. Galatians 4:4 says, "In the fullness of time, God sent forth his Son to be born of a woman."
But while the curtain was closed, and while God was silent, his oppressed children were crying to him for deliverance.
Thank you.
God heard the cries of his people, just as he hears our cries today. And he sent the deliverer, his only son, the Savior, who is Christ the Lord.
And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed, and all went to be taxed, every one into his own city.
And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house of Mary, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child.
And so it was that while they were there,
sleeping at night, sleeping at night.
Through the sleeping Adonai, the silence of Christmas was beautifully broken. A new song had been born. The Word became flesh and came to live among the very people he had created. A symphony of sound began that night that still echoes throughout the world today. From the cries of a tiny infant king to the multitudes of heaven's citizens shouting his praises from the night sky, the time for silence was past, and the time for rejoicing had come. That moved the hand of God.
crippled by life, and to those who have lost hope, and to the ones who see themselves as damaged.
Unto those who work hard and yet still struggle to make ends meet. Unto the people who fail the same test again and again. Unto those who hurt.
Unto those who are paralyzed.
Thank you.
this child, this Messiah, this Savior, delivers us today the same way he has delivered his people since Bethlehem. He gives us his own righteousness.
How can we respond to such an amazing, undeserved gift? We cannot be silent. For if we remain silent, even the rocks will cry out in praise in our place. And so we join the great psalmist in exclaiming, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Who forgives all your iniquities? Who heals all your diseases? Who redeems your life from destruction? Who crowns you with loving kindness and tender mercies? Who satisfies your mouth with good things?